Home Assistant 2023.6 was just released and I will jump right into what's fresh, but before that I want to say that the new things will be ordered in ascending order, starting from the least exciting and ending with the most exciting new features. So stick with me till the end and you'll be able to see the most interesting things. A quick spoiler alert, the Home Assistant integrations dashboard is now changed. But before that, let's see the other new stuff. There are three new entity types in the Home Assistant 2023.6 release. And these are date, time and daytime. This entity allowed to be used by Home Assistant custom and official integrations so that they can provide input controls for the UI. No integrations are using them yet, as they're quite new. But we'll see what will be the future state of these new entities. Moving to something more exciting that will be available from Home Assistant 2023.6 and onwards, namely related information. A new related menu is now visible on several dialogs like media players and in the blueprint section. If you click on a related button in a media player dialog, you probably see the integration that provides this media player, the device name, the area, the related entities, and is this part of any automations or scripts. And if, for example, you go to the blueprint section of Home Assistant, and if you click on the three dots menu, and then on show automations using this blueprint button next to the one of your blueprints, and if you actually have automations that are created out of this blueprint, they will be shown as related, which is kind of nice because you can keep an eye on them that way. Also, if you try to delete a blueprint and there are automations created from this blueprint, Home Assistant will know that and it will show you a warning message. Something even more interesting is the light entity dialog improvements with favorite colors. That means that the light entity dialog is now a bit changed in this latest Home Assistant release, so that the percentage of the light if it supports dimming is now visible at the top, and there is a text showing when was the last change of the state of this light, which is kind of nice. What is even nicer is that at the bottom, you can set your favorite colors as quick selection list. That way, you can switch your lights between predefined by you colors very quickly. And here is some heavy front-end lifting. If you hold on some of the predefined colors, similarly to an iOS device, all the colors will start to jiggle. And from there you can change the color so that it stays as your new quick selection. You can change the order by drag and drop or remove them completely. By the way, if some of the terms that I'm using are not so clear for you, not because of my perfect English, but because you're just not sure what their meaning is, then you can download my smart home glossary that is coming as a PDF document. And it is full of simple but yet useful explanations of the most common smart home words and acronyms. And it is absolutely free. Moving forward, in our Home Assistant 2023.6 new features ranking, and it is time for some serious copy-pasting. Every trigger, every condition and every action in the automation editor can be now copied and pasted from within the automation. But that is not a big of a deal, isn't it? What is a big deal is that you can copy and paste between different automations or between existing automations and new ones that you are currently creating. For example, you can even copy a trigger and paste it as a wait for trigger action. All of that is a good time saver and brings a lot of comfort, so I highly appreciate that new feature. But for you, it can be otherwise, so you can share what you think in the comments. From Home Assistant 2023.6 and onwards, you can use your existing NAS or network attached storage if you have one in Home Assistant. That includes local network drives and shares from drives like Synology, QNAP, TrueNAS and so on. You can add these shared folders from the storage menu in Home Assistant at Network Mount. Also from there, from the storage menu, you can see your already added mounts and you can manage them. But what is the big deal about that? Well, if you have a media folder somewhere, you can easily add that media to Home Assistant and use it that way. Or if you extensively record your security camera snapshots and video, you probably need a bigger space. This is the way to easily add more storage for such purposes. You could also use these network mounts as a backup target, so you could start backupping your Home Assistant somewhere outside of the device running Home Assistant, which is really a good idea. This new Home Assistant feature supports some of the most popular network sharing protocols, namely CIFS and NFS, so it should be fine no matter what type of NAS device or operating system you're using. As I quickly shared in the beginning, the integration dashboard is now looking a bit different. So if you have an integration with one device and another integration with 20 devices like ESP Home, for example, the integration cards will look very similar. Before that, these same multiple ESP Home devices were shown in a card with a scroller. Errors and warnings in the integration section are now looking a bit different, which makes everything much more consistent and ordered. Also, there is now a good visual indication showing which integration is cloud-based and which is custom. If it is a custom integration, the cloud is yellow, otherwise it is blue. These were just small visual changes, but what about controls that were available under the integrations card? They are all now moved to a new dedicated page, which is accessible by clicking on the cogwheel button next to the integration. From this page, you can configure, add, remove, reload, and everything the same way as before. Who doesn't like better performance for free? If you are a Home Assistant OS, Home Assistant supervised, or Home Assistant container user, you don't have to do anything special to get this performance boost caused by the newer and faster 3.11 version of Python. You just have to update your Home Assistant as usual, and that is it. You'll be in turbo mode because Python 3.11 is more faster than its predecessor between 10 and 60%, which should result in faster Home Assistant experience. All of that is valid for the 96% of the Home Assistant users according to the Home Assistant analytics. On the other hand, if you are a Home Assistant core user, along with the Home Assistant update, you have to manually update your Python version to 3.11 and you have around 2 months time to do that. Or in other words, until Home Assistant 2023.8 release. I believe that if you are within these 4% of users, you will know what to do. If these Home Assistant installation types that I mentioned, again, these were Home Assistant OS, supervised, container and core, means nothing to you, then please feel free to join my free webinar about this topic where I will explain everything essential about these methods to start Home Assistant, plus one secret way to get started on a PC in under 5 minutes. A link is in the video description as well as on your screen. I'm Kirill, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!